Hey, haven't done a video in a little while. It's been a week of waiting. Have a bunch of stuff coming in. So before I even get to that, I'll talk about some of the things I did do. This is Man of War's jetpack, and I love it. It's cool. It's heavy. But for the bottom part here, he just sends this. And from what I'm being told, this is really not accurate. Even though you can see... Well, let's go back. So this goes here, obviously. And I've seen in pictures how it goes horizontal and vertical. It's been in both. I think it might have been this way in the stunt and this way in the hero. I basically was trying to find out in my pack, does it have to be this way or this way? Okay, so I'm not building this pack as of right now. My pack, this part was like part of the mold, so it wasn't an extra piece, and it was barely seen. Like, it had been just, I don't know if it's sanded too much, painted too much, whatever was the reason, you couldn't even make out the lines anymore. So I measured this and had somebody 3D print me one, and he actually did a beautiful job. So I glued this in, but I glued it in the direction that it was originally in the pack, because I didn't want to have a crisscross thing going on, because you could still sort of see it. So it ended up being this way. And I'm looking at it, I'm looking at a lot of reference photos, I'm going, I don't think that's right. I think it's supposed to be this way. I'm seeing more photos of it this way. But I'm also seeing the ears that come out the sides, whatever you call them, the ears, the tabs. And mine didn't have that. So then I find Machine Graphics website, and they make, in their picture, they have the one with the ears and they have the round one. And then in small letters it says, we don't make the round one anymore, as we found out it is inaccurate. So I'm like, why is Man of War still making a circle one? Why is Machine Graphics still have a picture of a circle one when it's not even, they're not even selling it anymore? So I was thinking, all right, I can make my guy just go back and add the ears on and whatever. So then I tried to take this off, didn't want to come off. I used a super glue, Zap-A-Gap and Zap Kicker. So it was like on there, but luckily this is pretty sturdy. I don't know what he uses for 3D printing, but it was pretty good. So I was able to get under and pop it off. It did take a lot of the pack with it. So I ended up cutting it out, and now I got a big hole there. And you can see that this fits in that hole. All right, and I can do it this way or this way, but I'm not going to use this. I've decided I am going to buy the Machine Graphics one, the metal one, who I believe goes this way and does have the ears. So that's coming, and that'll fit right inside there. In addition, I had to take these off, the piano keys, I think these are called, because I noticed when they were on, there was a gap. I didn't like it. I guess we can do it. So this was on here, but there was like a gap that I didn't like. So I took it off, luckily it popped right off, and I was able to Dremel it a bit so that I'll be able to get a much flusher fit here on the piano keys. So these have to get glued back in. I just got my glue and my spray yesterday, so that can happen very soon. So that's that. The dart had a big gap right here between the top and the bottom, missile, whatever this is, rocket. So I put my putty in here, sanded it, and then I had a smooth surface, which I then had to recreate a line around here because this is supposed to be a separate piece. So recreated that line, and then now that's all good to go. Remember that this goes inside here. It's gonna be awesome when it's done. This is a Sith Planet jetpack. So that's all jetpack stuff. I still need to, and I just got the putty today. I should show you. Oh, I'm so stupid, they're right here. So one other issue, which I can fix probably today if I wanted to. These things right here don't fit properly because they're getting sucked all the way in. And the reason for it is this piece right here is too skinny. So I have to build up this material right here, make it wider. And I don't know if I may even have to put some in here if that hole's too big so that this fits properly and that will correct. I want these to be able to come in and out just like the other people have with the hooks or whatever. So also this thing right here, these were like all wonky and not facing up and down like the way they're supposed to. So I popped those out, glued those back in. These are 3D print pieces made for me. Those are put in. So we're making progress there. Some other things I got this week is this thing right here. This is by Tusk I can't remember the name of the vendor right now. Something with Tusk. And it's a replica of that. And that goes obviously back here. So I just have to figure out, like, I'll have to look at pictures. I don't know if it goes this way or this way, upside down, whatever. It sort of kind of looks like it might go this way facing up. So I guess the box would be to the left, if that's correct. That's just the way it looks in there now. I notice it doesn't go all the way down. I don't know if that's correct or incorrect. So I'm gonna Dremel out these and file them. I know there's supposed to be something back here along the whole way down. So I'll put this in, it'll cover as much as it covers. And then I guess I'll just put plastic underneath there to cover up the rest of the holes. I do have the dental files that go here, the actual, you know, things that poke in there. So I'll be able to put those in when it's ready as well. Excuse me. In regards to the helmet, I also got this cool thing for like $7 or $8. I think it came from England. Just another semi-accurate sort of chin strap, which you can use. Company here, Delta Plus. You just put some Chicago screws in there, and this can help keep it all together. I've never used a chin strap before. I know one of my buddies uses it on his TK. Most of my helmets are tight enough that I don't really need them, but the Boba might be loose. Okay, one other thing. Started printing stencils for the jetpack. So I figured out that I had to reduce it to 88% because this jetpack is a bit smaller. And when I put it on there, it pretty much fits where it's supposed to at 88%. So I'll be able to hopefully start tackling this jetpack soon in regards to paint. Okay, the last cool thing is this. I saw somebody on Instagram with a really cool Boba Fett toy. I have the big one in the back there. Can you see it? I'll use my knife right back there. I think that's Hot Toys. And it's awesome, and it's pretty accurate, but like I think it's got a lot of pre-pro stuff, like the gauntlet's yellow, it's got a gigantic flamethrower, whatever. So I don't see a lot of accurate, just ROTJ hero type stuff. So I found this toy on Instagram, and I was like, oh my god, what is that? And this guy tells me what it is, and I look it up, and it's fairly cheap in terms of what those things normally cost. So this is from www.bbts.com. It is a Return of the Jedi figure, and I'm hoping it's a figure because then I started clicking and I was like, tell me this is not just a bust. If it's just a bust, I'm gonna be pissed. I mean, it's still cool, but I wanted the entire figure, so I hope it's the entire figure. It is the entire figure, okay. Big Bad Toy Store is what it's called. And comes nicely wrapped in bubble wrap, you can see. And I'll take that out. Mafex, M-A-F-E-X, number 25, Medcom toy, Boba Fett, Return of the Jedi version, action figure. And there he is. Of course, I'm going to open him up in a second. And supposedly, he's pretty poseable. So we're going to see. But I'm excited for this guy. Because he's not gigantic like that one. He's a little bit more, you know, like action figure size. A lot of people keep these things in the boxes. I do not. I like having them out. I like touching them, playing with them. I mean, I don't play with them, but, you know, I want access to them. I don't like them in the packaging. So, looks like there's a stand on the bottom. You know, people like to keep all their original packaging and, you know, the resale value and the value. I don't care about the value. The value is to me. No one else is going to own this. I'm not going to sell it. It's mine. So I don't care about all that. The only time packaging comes into play is if I'm going to move and I need the box to move it so it doesn't break. Okay, so it looks like this thing gets stuck in there. And I guess this goes in here. Just guessing. Probably something like that. It's got like different choices of places you could put it. All right. So it's a double insulation. It's not taped. Wow.
Here's Boba Fett. He's got a... Okay, so his helmet's like in a clamshell protected, I think. Is it clamshell? I don't want to break his little visor. Really should have my glasses on. I can't see. All right. I have a razor blade right here. No, better yet. I have Lexan scissors. So I'm going to try to cut this off carefully. My tongue always comes out whenever I'm concentrating. Oh God. Don't want to break it. Okay. Easy. There we go. Is there any other packaging on there?
No.
Okay, so there he is. Hard to focus. Let me see if I can. Problem is I'm in the shot as well. I put him in the middle. Does that help? Oh, how funny. So I should post a picture. The weathering is not right on his helmet. See that big scoopy line? The funny thing is in Rick's armor, that there was a nasty long line just like that one in his armor. So this is accurate to Rick's old armor. Yeah, pretty cool. So he can go up and down this way, up and down this way, and go out, up and down. The looks like the shoulders do move a bit when you go up and down. The shoulders move with it. Cape's kind of hard and stiff. The knees do bend, as do the feet and the toes. He's got 4 shin tools. They do not come out, I don't think. Just double check. Well, I could be wrong. You know what? I don't want to pull them. They might come out, but I'm not going to pull on them. His pouches are the same color, and they seem to be off-whitish, so I don't think that's too correct. He has 3 hoses, which one of them is still under his shirt. I guess I'll have to stick the other ones back under there. So yeah, anyway, here's the back, the jetpack. There's the beacon. These thruster thingies do move. The rocket is all one piece, the helmet, side to side, forward and back. I had heard there was a seam in the neck seal and you actually could spin it. Okay. So, does that go around his neck, his waist? How does that work? I don't even know. I guess it could go around his waist. Oh, this opens. Okay. So you can open that up and then clamp it around him somehow. Let's see. So he comes with his blaster and 3 other sets of hands. There is, I guess that's his gun hand. I'm gonna put that one in now. They just pull right off. I'm gonna put the gun in the hand first. Really should be wearing my glasses.
Sorry if you can't see. Just don't want to break any fingers off. I do that. I'll buy a toy and then I break it the first day. Okay. Got that done. Cool. There is a little hole there. Not the easiest to just stick in. Keeps moving. I mean, it's on, but I don't feel like that's really on. Okay, so then there's a fist in the right hand. You could have that. Or a fist in the left hand. Guess if he can box. So this must be his other gun hand. Oh, yeah. Didn't fall in all the way. Come on, Boba. Hold your gun. Basically, you get the idea. So, I like it. 17-minute video. Sorry, way too long. But if you're looking for a Boba Fett toy, this is pretty cool. All right, we'll see you next time.